It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project scenario, your application runs in Google Kubernetes Engine or GKE. You want to use Spinnaker with the Kubernetes provider V2 to perform blue-green deployments and control which version of the application receives traffic. What should you do? Straightforward question which says that you're already using Spinnaker, you've got a blue-green deployment, and you want to control whether the blue deployment receives traffic or the green deployment receives traffic. How should you go about doing this? Before I answer this question though, let me be very open with you with my knowledge and experience. When I took the practice test, this was the only question I got wrong. I just did not know Spinnaker. I have not used Spinnaker before on any projects, though I've done a couple of labs probably on quick labs, though I can't really remember that either. I have not used Spinnaker in the real world, so I did not know this very well. Why am I still insisting that I do this question? So that you have a chance to know how Spinnaker works to an extent, and also that you get some impetus to go study Spinnaker, even if you have not used it in your project until now. So usually all these questions are directed at project scenarios, and we are trying to work through it as if we were doing a real world situation. But of course, sometimes you need to take it up as if you are learning for the exam itself. And in this case, even if you do not have an immediate use of Spinnaker or you're not using it, please go read the documentation, which is very good, and understand the architecture, understand how it is going to work, what is the intention of it, and what are all the suggested and recommended approaches of working with Spinnaker. Now, I went and read the documentation and I figured out a few things. We will walk through the options now and we will learn through that. In answering this question, there are two sets of options. Option A and B suggest that we use a Kubernetes replica set, whereas C and D suggest that we use a Kubernetes deployment. Our first approach with answering this question should be to eliminate one of this. For that, I go look at the documentation. And like I said, the documentation is very good. It's fairly detailed. And in the section under managing traffic using Kubernetes manifest, which is directly what the question is related to, because it says this guide shows the basics of how to manage traffic during deployments using Kubernetes provider V2. Later on in the page, under routing traffic during a deployment, specifically for blue-green, the title itself says that you must use replica sets. Why? Let me read that line out for you. Spinnaker manages traffic using labels and has to edit them on running resources. Given that edits to deployment objects trigger rollouts, the only way to carry out blue-green deployments without editing the service object directly is using replica sets. So if you used Kubernetes deployment, it is going to trigger a new rollout. And that doesn't work well with how Spinnaker manages the system. Therefore, reading this directly out of the documentation, we know that option C and D, which is to use Kubernetes deployment, would be the wrong approach. We have to use a Kubernetes replica set. Given that, the next thing we need to now see is between A and B, do we create a new service each time? Or do we update the existing replica set? The answer to this is in the same line that we were reading earlier. The only way to carry out blue-green deployments without editing the service object directly is using replica sets, which are safely edited in place by Spinnaker. So Spinnaker manages the replica sets, and when you have an updated version of the service to deploy, do not create a new service each time. Instead, allow Spinnaker to edit the replica sets. Therefore, in this case, the right option would be B, and we can eliminate A, which is creating a new service. So with that, we know that the option is clearly B. As I said, it was a fairly straightforward question once you've gone through the documents, but please make an effort to go figure out Spinnaker, do a couple of labs, it's available on Quick Labs, and go through the architecture and concepts on which Spinnaker is based. If you're interested in picking up loads more learning on Google Cloud, go ahead and subscribe right away.